Hello friends, in this lecture we will discuss some of the previous year questions or good questions of Qing model. So I have written three questions, so we will solve each and every questions just by using those formulas which I have already told you in the previous lectures. Okay, I have already given you a set of formulas, okay, and I have told that these were the first set of formulas and the second set of formulas I will be telling you in the upcoming lectures. So with the help of those given formulas, and I have already told you that those formulas are more important from the examination point of view, okay, directly questions are going to be asked on those formulas, okay, those first set of formulas. So you need to remember each and every formulas. So the three questions has been given, the two question, look, question number 2 and this question number 3, it has been already asked in the gate examination, okay. So look at the first question. The first question says that the number of persons arriving at service station is 8 customers per hour, okay. It is 8 customers per hour, and what it is given, it is arrival, okay. So it is basically what? It is basically arrival rate, and arrival rate was denoted by lambda. So here lambda is 8 customer per hour, and the service pattern, okay, or you can say the service provider takes 5 minutes per customer, okay. The service provider takes 5 minutes per customer. So it is given, it is not the service rate, okay. You can see, we know that the unit of service rate was denoted by mu. The unit of service rate was number of customer per unit time, okay, number of customer per unit time, but here it is given 5 minute per customer, it is given time per customer, it means it is given 1 upon mu, okay. We have been provided with the value 1 upon mu, so that 1 upon mu is known as inter service time, okay. On an average, then determine these followings. Average number of customer in the system. Okay, you already know the formula. Average number of customer in the system. Average number of customer in the queue. Average waiting time of a customer in the system. And average time of customer in the queue. Okay, so these are very much simple. Just we have to look at these things. Okay, that the unit was number of customer per unit time. But here we are provided with time per customer, okay. So we have to convert it, okay. These are the small points which are going to provide you some confusion, okay. So just read the question very carefully, okay. Read the question very carefully, it should be a habit. And the second question, it is a gate 1 marks question, very simple. It is a given that for a single server queue, okay, for a single server queue, we know that single server queue and multi server queue, okay, it means the server is 1. For a single server queue, the mean arrival time, the mean arrival rate is equals to 8 per hour, it means we are provided with what, lambda, and the mean service rate is 12 per hour, so we are provided with mu. Directly they have given lambda and mu, and what they are asking, the expected number in waiting line, okay, expected number in waiting line. Waiting line means queue, okay. So you have to apply the formula of LQ, okay, very simple, directly apply the formula. And here at a workstation, 5 jobs arrive every minute, okay, 5 jobs arrive every minute. Look, it can be, it is not only about arriving of a person, okay, jobs can also arrive, okay, okay. In the industrial applications also we use this type of models where jobs are waiting in the queue to get the processing, okay. So 5 jobs arrive every minute, it means number of customer per unit time, okay, number of customer, 5 jobs per unit time, so it is arrival, so we can say it is lambda. And the mean time spent on each job in the workstation is 1/8 minute, okay. The mean time spent on each job is 1/8 minute. So here also 1/mu is given, okay, 1/mu is given. So what they are asking, that the mean steady state number of jobs in the system, so they are basically asking L Yes, number of jobs in the system, it means L. Yes, okay. And they have directly not given mu. They have given 1 by mu. Okay, they have given 1 by mu. You can see the mean time spent on each job. It means they have given time per job. Okay, time per job. See, each job. Okay, it should be jobs per unit time. But they have given time per job. It means they have given 1 upon mu. So, you have to convert it. You have to convert it. So, we will do it one by one. So, from the first question, we have been given with the data. Okay, the given data is, look here, arrival is 8 customer per hour. So, lambda is 8 customer, number of customer per hour. So, lambda is directly given. And we know that lambda is going to follow the Poisson's distribution. And the second one is, and the service provider takes 5 minutes per customer on an average. Okay, it is given service, it is given that service, it is given that it takes 5 minutes per customer. Okay, so here you can see the unit, it is customer per hour, and here it is given time or minute per customer. So mu is not given, this is 1 by mu. Okay, it is 1 by mu, and we know that mu is going to follow which distribution? Exponential distribution. Okay, mu follows exponential distribution. Okay, so 1 by mu follows, you can say it follows Poisson's distribution. Okay, just opposite. So we have to find mu. So what you can do? You can do that in 5 minutes, one customer is served. Okay, so in 1 minute, how many customer? 1 by 5 customer. Okay, in 1 minute, how many customer? 1 by 5 customer. So basically, we have to convert the unit. So it is given in hour. So what we can do? 1 by 5 into 60. We will get 12 customer per hour. So mu you are going to get is 1 by 5 into 60. That is 12 customer per hour. Okay, you can convert it. So it is also now given in customer per hour, number of customer per hour. And it is also given number of customer per hour. Both should be in same units. Then only you can proceed for the calculations. So how you did it? 5 minutes, one customer. So 1 minute, 1 by 5 customer. Okay. So in 1 hour, 1 by 5 into 60. So it is customer per hour. So now look what they are asking. The first question they are asking that what is the average number of customer in the system. What is the average number of customer in the system? So what is the formula? First, number of customer in the system is LS, and LS was rho upon 1 minus rho. After solving it, it is lambda upon mu minus lambda. What is the value of lambda? Lambda is 8 customer per hour, mu is 12 minus 4. So it is going to be 12 minus 8. So it is going to be 2. Okay, so average number of customer in the system is going to be 2. Okay, so first we got the answer. Very simple, directly formula. Just you have to take care of these things. Okay, just look for these units, customer per hour, and both should be either hour or second or minute. Okay, same unit should be there. The second one is average number of customer in the queue. So they are asking LQ. It was rho square upon 1 minus rho. So it is coming lambda square upon mu into mu minus lambda. So lambda square is 8 into 8. Mu is 12. And mu minus lambda, it is going to be 4. So from here, you can solve 2 by 6, 8 by 6. Okay, it is coming 8 by 6, I think it is coming 1.33. okay, 1.33. You can just check the answer. Okay, you can just check the answer that it is coming 1/1.33. Okay. Now the third they are asking that average time a customer spends in the queue. Average time, third one, average time a customer spends in the queue. So from the Little's law, you can see they're asking that about system. Okay. From Little's law, you know that LS can be written as product of lambda into WS. And this WS was the average waiting time in the system. S for system. So you have to find this WS value. So it is going to be lambda LS upon lambda. LS was lambda upon mu minus lambda. So it is coming 1 upon mu minus lambda. I have already told you to not remember this WS formula. Okay, just remember this Little's law. Little's law. So 1 upon 12 minus 8. Okay, it is coming 0.25 hours, or you can write 15 minutes. Okay, multiplied with 60, you will get 15 minutes. So the average waiting time the customer is going to spend in the system is 15 minutes. Now the last one, they are asking that average time a customer spends in the queue. Okay, so the last one, again apply the Little's law. For Q, you can write LQ equals to lambda into WQ. Okay, so from here WQ is going to be LQ by lambda. LQ by lambda square upon mu into mu minus lambda. One lambda will be cancelled. So we will be left with lambda upon mu into mu minus lambda. So it is going to be lambda is 8. 8 upon 12 into 4. Okay. So it is going to be 2 by 12. So answer will be 2 by 12. So the answer will be lambda is 8 and it is 12. Okay. So the answer is 1 by 6. It is coming 10. Okay, it is coming 10 minutes. Okay, it is coming 10 minutes. So multiplied with 60 to convert it into minutes. Okay, so it is coming to be 10 minutes. So this is one of your answers. First answer, second answer. Okay, so 2, 1.33, 15 minutes and 10 minutes. So first question has been solved. So basically now we will go for our second question. Okay, second problem. The second problem, you can see it. It said that for a single server queue, the mean arrival rate is equal to 8 per hour. Okay, so lambda they have directly provided 8 per hour, and the mean service rate is, okay, just look at the unit. It is customer per hour, so you don't have to do anything. The expected number in the waiting line, okay, the expected number in the waiting line. So they are asking waiting line or waiting queue. So they are asking about LQ. So LQ is going to be lambda square upon mu into mu minus lambda. So it is 8 into 8 upon 12 into 12 minus 8. Just like the previous one, same data. It is coming 64 upon 12 into 4, 16 by 12, it is coming 1.33. okay, 1.33 customers or jobs will be waiting in the queue. Okay, 1.33 customers will be waiting in the queue. So just everything is given, just you have to apply the formula. Okay, okay, I'm again saying that those first sets of formulas were very much important, so you have to remember the formulas directly. No need to go for the derivations. The last question was, it is saying that at a workstation 5 jobs are arriving. Okay, 5 jobs are arriving every minute. It means lambda is given, it is given number of customer or 5 jobs per minute. Okay, so lambda is given. And they are saying that the mean time spent on each job in the workstation is 1/8 minutes. So they have given not mu, they have not provided, they have given 1 by mu. So 1 by mu is given 1 by 8, 1 by 8 minutes, 1 by 8 minutes per job. You can see. So we will convert it into mu. So it is going to be 8 jobs per minute. Okay. So we are asking that the number of jobs in the system. Number of jobs in the system. Okay, you can convert it. Okay, you can write here in 1 by 8 minutes, one job is arriving. So in 1 minute, 8 jobs will be arriving. So 8 jobs per minute. So they are asking about LS. Number of jobs in the system, LS, that is lambda upon mu minus lambda. Our lambda is 5. Okay, lambda is always going to be less than or equal to this mu. I have told you. Okay, for our syllabus, lambda is going to be less than mu. Okay, otherwise the system is going to fail. Okay, otherwise the system is going to fail. And this mu minus lambda, 8 minus 5. So this is 5 by 3. So LS is coming 1.66. Okay, 1.66. So again, very simple. Okay, again very simple. Now, what is this system? Okay, a question arises that what is this system? Look here, again I am going to tell you. Earlier I might not have told you that what is system. Okay, so you can see that is what the, it was the calling population. Okay, it is the calling population and people are standing in the queue. Okay, people are standing in the queue or jobs are waiting in the queue to get the service. And here there is a server or window. So what is this? This is our queue. Okay, this is our queue. So what is the system? System is going to be queue plus, it is going to be queue plus, suppose the customer is getting the service. Okay, the customer is getting the service. Okay, so these are the waiting customers. Okay, these are the waiting customers and this customer is being provided the service. So the system is the customer who is waiting in the queue plus the customer who is getting the service. So this big box is going to make your system. Okay, so we can write that system is queue plus customer being served. Queue plus customer being served. Okay, so just keep it in mind that system is going to be queue plus customer who is being served. Okay, this queue, it means the waiting customer plus the customer who is being provided the service. So everything will come under your system. Everything is going to come under your system. So just remember it, because sometimes they are directly not going to write the word system. Okay, they are going to write find the number of customers who are in queue plus the customer being served. Okay, so they are directly not going to write the word system. They are going to write this word. Find the average number of customers who are waiting in the queue plus the customer who is being served. It means you have to understand that they are asking about system. Okay, so these were the three questions. More questions will be discussed, don't worry. So I have already made you to learn that how to apply those first sets of formulas in the questions. Okay, so just go through this lecture carefully. Thank you.